there's been a lot of talk in the past decades about men are from Venus and women are from, I'm sorry, men are from Mars and women are from Venus. Hi guys, this is Dale Vandersand, Real Vocal Coach, here to react to Aurora's new release, Exist for Love. Another release during this time of the corona quarantine. And so people are being really prolific, very creative during this time. And let's take a look and see what Aurora has to offer us today. Okay, she's referencing Botticelli's Birth of Venus, the 15th century Renaissance painting.
They say there is a war between the man and the woman.
She's saying there's a war between the man and the woman, but there's a very pleasant, soft sound with the guitar strumming and her very delicate vocals.
Take me in, and everything in me begins to feel like I belong, like everybody needs a home.
In this song, she has such a light touch to her voice. It reminds me of the singer Twiggy and a little bit of Jane Birkin, the American who sang in France. I like her performance. Her arm gestures are very evocative. Like a statue come to life.
I feel like I exist for love. Like I exist for love.
Of course, she's wearing pearls. She just came out of a scallop.
Only for love.
An oyster, I guess.
I can't imagine.
That's a scallop.
How it is to be forbidden from loving.
Visuals are beautiful.
Cause when you walked into my life, I could feel my.
The colors keep changing, but these pastels. Ooh, the harmony's nice, like for harmonizing with yourself. And it goes orange. It's very interesting visual. It's very simple.
The only thing that makes me whole, I know it sounds like the love, but you really need to know we are leaning out for love and we will lean for love forever. I know.
Leading out for love and we will lean for love forever. Very nice, that little bounce in the music. This orchestral sound with the violins, and this love song, of course, it's a nostalgia for a different kind of music of a different time. Band dancers. This is lush and lavish. These lyrics are great. Ocean in my veins. It's very romantic. She's so original. Fades away with the camera coming back. Wow! The simplicity of it is deceiving. It's simple because it's a very consonant song, very easy song to listen to. But with the video attached to it, there's a lot of creativity here. she's saying always in the shell, but she's giving us a lot of life in her body language and in her vocals as well. Her choice of just being really easy and free and letting just that wisp of a voice sing the song. Other music of hers has a little bit more depth to the sound, or her top voice gets a little bigger. Here she's choosing to be extremely small in the sound, but the effect is big. We have to go back to the title, Exist for Love. She's obviously being Venus. As I said, this references the 15th century Renaissance painting, The Birth of Venus. Venus was the Roman goddess of love and beauty, fertility, and sex. Venus's entire purpose was about love, about embodying love in a human form. In Greek mythology, it was Aphrodite. Venus is slightly different than Aphrodite. Aphrodite was much more pure. Her purpose was a little bit more narrow. Venus was a little bit more extensive in what she represented to the Romans. I understand that she wanted to present at this time a love song, something that didn't have a lot of angst to it, something that would create more anxiety for people, which is kind of a gift. If we look back at her other albums, I have that up here, her recent ones, since 2018, she had Infections of a Different Kind. There she gets very deep. And then she came out in 2019 with A Different Kind of Human. The first one is called Step 1, and the second one is Step 2. This one is listed as EBA. It's not yet known whether it'll be part of an album or whether it'll remain a single. Looks like it'll be part of an album, actually. So I wonder if it'll be a Step 3 or whether she'll just completely take this in a whole different direction. She's almost being a siren, which is a whole different mythology. Venus as a siren, that works. In the way she sings and in the lull of the song, in the lullaby of the song, she's kind of calling out to us to be persuaded, to be seduced by her sound, by the music. I'd love to go back and look at the lyrics, probably have a little bit more depth to them, considering who she is and what she always has to say. They say there is a war between the man and the woman. So right there, it's a love song, but she's talking about the tension that that occurs between Venus and Mars. There's been a lot of talk in the past decades about men are from Venus and women are from, I'm sorry, men are from Mars and women are from Venus. I've never felt like this before. My heart knew that I couldn't, and then you take me in. So that's very romantic. She found her soulmate. And when I take your hand, like the world has never held a man, I know I cannot heal the hurt, but I will hold you here forever if I can, if I can. So, in its being a love song, it's not without some depth. She's talking about a war, some tension, and hurt, so there's depth there. And love has come into her life, and it seems like it has a healing aspect to it. Out for love, and we will lean for love forever, I know. Interesting choice of words, we will lean out for love, lean forever. She's not natively an English speaker, she's learned English very young, but that's an interesting way to say it, to lean into somebody that you love, to kind of lean together. You're having to balance the world, and you can do that best when you found your other half. And when you say my name, like white horses on the waves, I think it feels the same. White horses on the waves. She's playing with a lot of mythology here, not just Venus, but she's talking about the horses on the waves, the white horses on the waves, which are either Neptune's or Poseidon's horses, also called the hippocamp, the horse from the sea with the webbed feet, the hippocamp. And here's what I liked before. I think it feels the same as an ocean in my veins, and you'll be diving in like nothing is out of place, and we exist for love, only for love. There's some imagery for you too. An ocean in my veins. Veins are, you know, running all throughout you and is a life force. And an ocean, of course, is vast and salty and you know, earthy in that way, that it's salt as a mineral. Maybe I'm getting too much into this, but the images, the senses of this are coming to me. We are here to love. And perhaps that is the message of this, not just that love is a beautiful thing or beautiful feeling, but that it's what makes the world go round. And we've heard that before too. It's just a different way of saying it. And she again brought us something extremely original, extremely colorful. So we have the three kinds of mythologies going on. Venus, Roman, the Hippocamp, which is, I think, originally Greek, but Roman and Greek. And then there's the Siren, the Lorelei, which is a Germanic legend as well, all having to do with water, having to do with the sea or the river, luring in the sailor in the case of the Lorelei. These are all wonderful stories. If you don't know them, to explore mythology is really a delight, so I suggest that you go and do that. She obviously knows all these things, and she's a very, very smart woman. It's inspiring her, which in turn inspires us. So I'm always inspired by those stories, and I hope this video has inspired you as well. It has me. So thank you very much for joining me in this exploration. If you like this video, please click on subscribe and click on the bell, ding, for notifications. I'll have a lot more videos coming up very soon. There's been a lot of requests in the past couple videos I've done. I've started the channel only recently. And till then, take care, be safe, good health to you and your loved ones at this time. This is Dale Vandersand, Real Vocal Coach, signing off. Thanks for watching.